Welcome, my dear student. So today we are going to start with Standard 7th, Unit 2, 2.1 poem from a railway carriage. The poem so beautifully written by Robert Louis Stevenson. Let us start with the paragraph that is, faster than fairies, faster than witches, bridges and houses, hedges and ditches. Your fairies are the pari, witches are the magician women, bridges are the pools, houses is ghar, hedges are the green bushes through which we can pass, and ditches are like khai, we say, where the river flows around. And charging along like troops in a battle, charging means the railway is charging themselves like the troops, and troops are the soldiers in the battle. All through the meadows, meadows are the green garden where flowers and everything we can see, like the horses and the cattle, where we can see the horses, fastest move of running horses and the cattle. So the scenario is so beautifully, yeah, children. This all thing is being seen from the railway. All of the sight of the hill and the plain fly as thick as driving rain, and ever again in the wink of an eye, painted station whistle by. Here, everything we can see with the wink of an eye, that is एक ही पलक झपकते हम बहुत सारा सिनेरियो देखते हैं. दैट इज हिल वी कैन सी, द प्लेन्स वी कैन सी द ड्राइविंग रेन एंड द पेंटेड स्टेशन, डिफरेंट डिफरेंट स्टेशन वी कैन सी विच इज विस्लिंग, विच इज ऑल द सिनेरियो इज कमिंग एंड गोइंग. ओके, आँख झपकने से पहले ये सारे सिनेरियो हम लोग देखते हैं. दैट इज द रेलवे इज मूविंग सो फास्ट. I hope you can imagine the train is moving so fastest, okay? Here is a child who clambers and scrambles. A small child who is very excited, and he is not sitting in one place. He is just jumping from here to there. That is called clambers and scramble. That is the excitement he has in himself. All by himself and gathering brambles. Or wo itna excited hai ki wo khud ko hurt karke le raha hai. What do you mean by bramble? Bramble wo pata hai, wo bushes jo kaati wale thorns hote hai. That is called brambles. Here is a tramp who stands and gaze. Tramp is an old English. Jo poor people, jo poor person hota hai, jo khade reke continuously dekh raha hai train ko. And there is a green for stringing the daisies. Daisies is the white flower, very acha. Very good fragrance come in it. Okay, so stringing the daisies means the person has made the daisies. We make anklets been made by daisies. Okay, here is a cart run away in a road. Okay, a bullock cart which is running away in the road, lumping along with man and load. Man is carrying the load in the cart and he is doing his daily schedule. And here is a mill and there is a river. At a glance, we can see a man who is carrying the load, a poor man who is doing his work in a mill. Mill is the old company, okay? A river we can see, and all these things we can see, each a glimpse and gone forever. At a time, we can see all this scenario and which is gone forever. Ever. How beautifully this Robert Louis Stevenson has written the poem. Everything, each and every memory which we see in the train, he has put everything in it. Okay? Next is, okay children, let us start with English workshop. That is meaning. Witch, a woman who is believed to have magical power. Hedge, a line of bushes or small tree planted very close together. Ditch is a long, narrow, open channel dug into ground, usually at the side of road or field. Troops, a group of soldiers. Meadow, a field with grass and often wild flowers in it. Bramble, a wild bush with thorns produce blackberries. Lumping, moving with jerks. Glimpse, something you see for a very short time. Answer the following next. That is, what does the railway carriage move faster than? Fairies and witches. How do the fast moving bogies look like? Troops in a battle. What does the train pass through? It passes through bridges, houses, hedges and ditches. Right, true or false in bracket. The train is faster than fairies and witches. True. There is no bridge on river on its way. False. The child clambers and scrambles. Of course, true. Okay, now our next thing is, pick up the rhyming words from the poem and add more. That is, road, load, showed, code. River, forever, never, clever. Witches, ditches, pitches, riches. Cattle, battle, settle, castle. Rain, plain, gain, train. Here is filling the blanks with the given words. Dash are imaginary things or person. Once I was passing the dash, dense forest. After a long dash, we got freedom. The thief went out of the sight in the dash of an eye. We saw a dash of the moon on a cloudy night. So here I have given the answers. Let's see. And the answers are fairies, true, battle, wink and glimpse. Okay. Next is, make word adding ing and write in your own sentences. That is, cut will be cutting, run, running, get, getting, put, putting, and sit will be sitting. Okay, now we will make a sentence of it. That is, boys are swimming in the river. Mohan is putting his cap on the table. The woodcutter is cutting a tree. Girls are running in the field. We are getting gift from our father. Okay, so we have put ing and we have made the sentence also. Let us start with the root words. That is, separate the root word with given word. Here, the words are charging, fairies, driving, stringing, daisies and gathering. The answers will be, charging is charge, fairies are fairy, driving is drive, stringing is string, daisies is daisy, gathering is gather. Next is, we have to again make the sentence of it. Dogs charge on stranger. I saw a fairy in a dream. We should drive our vehicles carefully. My friend brought a long string for me. Daisy is a kind of flower. Children gather many things around them. Okay, so we have framed the sentence of that words which was being given. Okay, now let us start with the next thing. That is, we have to write the following. The sight seen through a railway carriage mentioned in the first stanza. It was bridges, houses, hedges, ditches, meadow, horses and cattle. The sight mentioned in the second stanzas were hills and plains and painted station. The sight mentioned in the third stanzas were the child gathering brambles and tramp and green grasses. So these were the three sights. Next is, think and answer. Why are the sights said to fly? The sights are said to fly to give us an idea of the great speed of a train. Does the last line make you happy or sad? Why? This last line make me sad because I will like to see the sight again and again. Here you can give the own answer also. Okay. Hope you like my video, children.